Hey guys, it's your boy Gripperz, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Chrome over last time I left off. I picked up the win over Spurs in the FA Cup semi-final, and I'm in the final. But before I play the final, I must play the final game of Season 1 of the Premier League against Middlesbrough. After this, I will be lifting the Premier League. Well, I won't be doing it myself. It'll be Hemmers Milner. This team is also going for perfect. 37 wins from 37 games so far. I did win all three of my the games I played off camera, as well as the game against Crystal Palace in the last episode. Which you saw, I picked up some good wins, and using the second team as well. Well, I beat West Ham 3-0, I beat Southampton 6-0, I scored a free kick with Tex Alexander-Arnold. I was really disappointed I wasn't recording for that. And I also defeated Watford. So I defeated three teams who are all going to be battling out, along with Leicester, for the final two relegation spots. And there is also a battle for fourth between Manchester City and Everton. Manchester United are guaranteed not to get top four because they are way too far down. Sixth, as you can see. But City and Everton are going to battle it out. Everton are playing Arsenal, and City are playing, I think they might be playing Watford.
Look at the amount of goals they've scored.
You can see how dominant I have been. All I have to do is beat Middlesbrough. I go 38-38 and win the Premier League. Perfect. Not much on the record whatsoever.
Big reshuffle for Liverpool. Lloris Karius is the goalkeeper today. Nathaniel Clyne starts with David.
So, yeah. Should be fun.
And the strike force, Sadio Mane joins up with Daniel Sturridge.
Great chat. And I actually have something to talk about because,
Gaston Ramirez starts.
As you're watching this, I'm recording this only a few hours, like an hour or so, like a few hours after I finished recording and uploading and all that good stuff, the video you saw on Friday night. So this will be going up on Monday, and there's the first score update. It's 1-0 to Arsenal, which gives City the opportunity to sneak into that top four spot. Again, Arsenal, another team who played too bad throughout the season. I think they're 14th. Or something like that. They're really far down the table. Well, so this win is, like, not important to them. But Everton could be giving up top four if that stays the way it is. Oh, that is a filthy challenge. Give that man a yellow card, please. He's referee. Thank you. But I want to talk to you guys about something, about goal line technology and how it fucked up. Let me explain what happened. I was playing just before I started half an hour or so ago, roughly, maybe an hour or ago, I played the game against West Ham. Off camera. These Premier League teams, they're not really too important. There's confirmation at the final against Manchester City and the FA Cup. But I played the game, and like I said, I beat him 3-0. Moya got a goal as did the returning Divo Origi. He managed to get him a goal as well. Well, but the first goal was a very odd goal. What happened was West Ham had the ball and they were running towards my goal with Fuguli. And Fuguli whips in a cross, but Diwara, my center defensive mid, he got back into the box and he cleared it out. So, and the ball came to Emery Moore, which started a counterattack. And I'm like, okay, this gives me a good chance. And I have the beating of the West Ham players for pace. I'm outpacing Winston Reid and Norvik. I don't know how to properly pronounce that dude's name. But any West Ham fans watching will know who I'm talking about. Most of you may know who I'm talking about anyway. I think he's Norwegian or something like that? I don't know. But you'll know the player if you follow the Premier League and or a West Ham fan. So I have the beating of them. As I stop to take the shot, Winston manages to slide across, and he kind of like gets in the way of Adrian comfortably getting it, and it bounces up. So it's almost like I chipped it, but I didn't. I shot it straight at goal. Well, thinking Moore would get the goal, I even tried to aim it away from Adrian, but the deflection took it up into the air like it was a chip. So I'm instantly already preparing for the corner. I'm thinking it's going to fly over the crossbar, go out for a corner. But no, it starts coming down, and I notice it's heading towards the goal. I see Cresswell. He desperately tries, and he does clear it away, but it crosses the line first, and goal line technology, he shows that to be true. Now, I looked at the replay very carefully, and there was no contact on the ball before the ball crossed the line after the deflection. So can somebody tell me how the game put it down as an Aaron Cresswell own goal? I mean, if it's anyone's own goal, it could be Winston Reid's. I don't know if the ball was going in without the deflection. It might not have been, so maybe it should have been given as a Winston Reid own goal and Everton equalized there against Arsenal. Maybe it should have been given as a Winston Reid own goal, but I looked at it and I could not see. It didn't touch Cresswell. He did not touch the ball until it had already passed the line. So I have absolutely no idea why the game gave it as an own goal for Cresswell. I was like, wow, that is completely a slap in the face of poor Cresswell. And he did not have his best game in considering that. Because for the second goal, he lost Moya. He was supposed to be marking Moya, but Moya got away from him and got the header on goal, and Adrian couldn't do anything about it. And so, overall, not the best defensive performance from Cresswell, but that own goal was really harsh because he didn't touch it before. Oh, what a goal from Sewell. That is his first goal for the club. What a time to score it. And what a goal it is. Look at this. Watch this again. The initial full shot is blocked by, I think, the room. And then the shot of dreams. How does a center back do this? That is some mad skill. Anyway, as I was saying, I don't understand how it gave it as a Cresswell own goal. I wish I could show you guys what happened. And maybe some of you noticed this before, maybe, I don't know. If any of you experienced something like this before or know why it might have get, maybe it did touch Creswell and I just didn't see it.
There goes the cross.
It must have been like a freaking nano touch, like the slightest touch. It must have made some kind of contact, right? Otherwise, it would have either given it as a Winston Reed own goal, or the goal would have been given to Moore. And I was right, Man City are playing well for the 1-1. Southampton 1-1. Watford are also the other team. Another team in Dragon Zone, as are Leicester. And West Ham. West Ham are winning, so they're looking safe. And the other team who are outside the relegation zone are Leicester. They just need a point, and they are getting that point. So as it stands, Southampton and Watford are both going down. They both need a win to have any chance of staying up, and they would need some sort of loss from our Leicester or West Ham, or even both. So it's looking like we'll be saying goodbye to Watford and Southampton. They will be joining Burnley, who are already relegated. In fact, they were relegated by myself. Oh, back when I played them in an earlier episode.
Well, they're in a good position here. And the cross comes in now.
So, yeah, I mean, it's a bit hard to describe what I'm trying to get across unless you've witnessed it or I had some, like, video proof. I wish I did. I wish I could show you, like, the instant replay. Maybe I should have been recording that match. Maybe that's what that's telling me. But I looked really hard. And I will say, I would bet money that it made no contact with Aaron Creswell before it crossed the line. I mean, if it is anyone's goal, it is in fact. Oh, and West Ham scored again. If it was an own goal, it's Winston Reed's own goal. If not, it's Emery Moore's goal. Why the game gave it to Creswell? Oh, I have absolutely no idea. Like I said, I wish I could show you what I was talking about. Maybe some of you, like I said, have experienced something like this to where you can say, oh yeah, that happened to me. Yeah. It feels it's a bit of a annoying because that's a goal that Moore could really use to, you know, just have the extra goal on his record for come the end of the season, because chances are he's not going to play in this match and he's not going to play in the FA Cup final, so that was his last game for the season. Unless there's an injury between now and the final, but even if that's the case, Divock Origi is back now, so he would be first choice, even though Moore has been fantastic.
Great work from the keeper. We've had an hour gone here, and still 30 minutes left.
And Moya has been fantastic in the games as well. He got a good amount of goals in those three games. And he picked up the hat-trick against Watford. And he scored a brace against Southampton. And like I said, he scored one goal against West Ham. So that actually gave him 6 goals against those three teams. So he finished with, like, I think it was 8 goals.
Makes a challenge here.
Actually checked. They actually put him like one behind Jamie Vardy, who's only scored 9. unless they aren't hadn't scored a goal by half time anyway. I don't think, and unless I missed it, nothing has come up that says they've scored anyway. In this situation, in this game, in the game they're playing now. But it's not looking like they're going to need it, as long as they don't concede, and as long as Southampton and or Watford don't win. Really, it's more for Watford, because Watford, if they, and Leicester, they could pass Leicester, but only on goal difference, or it might be Southampton. I know one of them can pass Leicester. Well, mathematically, really, they could both, but it would they would need an astronomical amount of goals for that to happen. So it's not looking like it's going to... It doesn't look like anything's going to happen for them. As Sadio Mane scores another goal. Well, I mean, he would score in, to wrap up the season, wouldn't he? Is that 35 goals? That might be 35 goals. Well, to be honest. Beautiful finish near post. How did he score that? Valdez should hang his head in shame. Oh, well. Got a nice seat. Is that... Hey, I was right. 35 goals. Look at that. What? I pulled that 35 out of nowhere. That was a badass guess. I have to give. I give myself great credit for that.
The goalkeeper. They should win now, shouldn't they? 2-0 here. Not much time to go. What impact will that have on the next game?
Well, Liverpool go up against Manchester City.
So yeah. All in all. Well, this season has been very successful. Well, the multiple wins over rivals like Manchester United, Manchester City, Arsenal, well, Everton, and Chelsea. Well, I've beaten everyone. There's not a team I have failed to beat. I've won every single game.
A couple of yards.
Because of that little error with the Sunderland game earlier in the season.
Free kick given.
And then don't worry, I didn't forget.
To make the most of it.
But the game isn't gonna correct that error, so as far as it's concerned, I'm gonna be perfect. Because Middlesbrough are not gonna get back into this with even with 4 minutes of added time.
Simple as you think to throw the ball to one of your teammates.
It's time to pop the corks of the champagne and celebrate the Premier League title. Oh, that was perfectly timed. Look at that. Full time whistle. There it is. It's celebration. Oh,
spirit.
Hey! This is good. This is probably going to make this so slightly longer than normal, but it's not a really... It's a big occasion to win the league.
So many months.
A lot of people might see this as perhaps a vision of the future. I don't know. I don't think so. I just want a top four in real life, to be honest. The game at the weekend against Southampton, which, when I'm recording this, hasn't happened. But when this goes up, it'll be Monday, and that match will have happened. That's the beauty of pre-recording, ladies and gentlemen. That game will just... That game will go a long way to telling us where Liverpool can stay semi-consistent and then perhaps give the title race another goal. or if they're just going to fade out and hopefully... Like, I will be happy with top four. I mean, if you can tell... If you can find me a Liverpool fan who would be disappointed to miss out on the title and not take and be, like, top... And if you say to him, but you got top four, and he's like, nah, I don't care. Or that doesn't matter, we should have won the league. Then that dude is an idiot. What is wrong with him? Because top four is the goal. I mean, first and foremost, it is the goal. While it would be great to get the league title if we can. I mean, if we can stay off the inconsistencies that we're known for, then yeah, and I know Leicester actually won their match, so everyone got relegated. Watford lost to Manchester City, which is a little consolation to Manchester City, because that's not going to mean shit to them, because they're not going to finish in the top four, because Everton were ahead of them. Everton actually beat Arsenal 2-1. I saw out of the corner of my eye at the top of the screen.
At the top of the table remain Liverpool with 114 points.
Courage, how did you not go up to 76?
In fourth, Everton with 59 points.
But you don't make any goddamn sense. I need to see how much I got there. Here.
Rising up the table.
Look at that. Profit 282.35 million. Damn.
And then reading up the table.
That's nice. Hello? Qualify to the Capital Champions Cup. Yeah, I did that. Hello? I won the league. That automatically qualifies me. I guess they'll take that off at the end of the season, once they review me, I guess? I don't know. Anyway, let's jump in to the final game of Season 1. The FA Cup final against Manchester City. Firmino and Sturridge are a little tired, but it shouldn't be too big of an issue because I'm going to do everything in my power to make sure that this does not go to extra time. Let's do this! I'm not even gonna bother playing the thing. I'm just gonna wait for the thing to come up. There it is. And straight into the game.
Well, it's
the FA Cup final! Woo!
The final of this competition, the final of the Emirates FA Cup, watched all around the world. And it's our privilege to watch it too, Alan, isn't it?
It is, and always sends a shiver down the spine. It really does. It's the most famous.
Let's do this. Nice early goal set the pace.
A couple of changes for Manchester City. Joe Hart starts in goal. Alexander Kolarov starts with Kyle Walker in the fullback position.
Coutinho
starts looking to recover his form. Sergio Aguero is the sole striker. This is the Liverpool side.
A Sterling starring, having only come on as a late substitute at the Capital One Cup final. I guess Manchester City are going to take this a little more seriously because they, you know, I am.
That can bring the best out of both of them.
chat.
Sadio Mane, he got away from Company. It's 1-0 in the 10th minute. And of course, it's that man again. And you just can't freaking stop him. Joe is not having a good time. Vincent Company makes an absolute tit of himself. And it's 1-0. And Company can only look in the mirror with why Sadio Mane has 2 FA Cup goals and it's 1-0 in the final.
Open the scoring, 1-0 here. Silva. Trying to find an opening. Panicking.
Oops. Oh yes, it was a fair challenge according to the referee. Sturridge. Oh come on! Now you stop it. How did he even hurt his shoulder? He didn't even land on it. It's fucking faking.
Bringing fresh legs and a fresh approach to the match.
Bullshit. Coutinho. Sadio Mane.
Some danger.
Oh, so Mendy with a great challenge to stop Mane getting a run in at the defense. Sturridge. Oh, I couldn't turn. Gundogan was right there up in my face.
Silva.
Thomas Milner. Roy playing his final game as a mainstay in the first 11. Is probably going to be starting the dudes come to start next season.
Wow, what a massive day this is for the football
fans. Milner is starting to decrease. Oh yes, Coutinho avoids the challenge from Kyle Walker and Daniel Sturridge makes it 2-0 and he scored in both finals against his former club. What are the chances of that?
It's come in from a
nodding, powering at her past Joe Hart, who freaking body scissors freaking Sadio Mane. Good to know he's got his priorities straight.
Restarting.
Instead of trying to prevent the header going in, he decided to do some wrestling with Mane.
They'll need to try and get the ball back now.
Or maybe he was taking Mane down to check for dandruff. This is Joe Hart we're talking about here.
Really tussling for the ball here.
Nice.
Very straightforward save for the goalkeeper.
There that.
Read the play well to intercept.
Mane.
Good forward play from them.
Sadio Mane. Chan 3-0. Oh, Emery Chan makes it 3-0, and that gives me a bit of breathing room. It's looking comfortable before the halftime whistle. Oh, it's great.
It is looking pretty much now that the victory is assured.
The composure from both Chan and Mane on the ball was brilliant. Instead, blue shirts around them for seemingly miles, and they didn't get to. Fair play.
In their first half. Fernandinho. Jesus Navas.
There's going to be a throw-in after that tackle. On the pitch, not quite.
Hey, it seems to be getting the Navas, though. Coutinho. Coutinho shrugs off the challenge from David Silva. Coutinho, Thomas Milner, oh, he didn't get a chance to take the shot up. Before I knew he was right in front of Hart. Hart was clearing up the ball. That's okay. Sadio Mane will make it 4-0. But right before the half. It's demolition stuff right now. Otamendi probably thought he'd done enough to get it away. Nope. He pretty much put it on a plate for Sadio Mane. And he to scoop into the net. Which I'm sure he felt very happy about. Ah, oh, it's brilliant.
His company.
I could chillax for the whole second half and they would still win. Oh, this is fantastic. Look at that. That tells you all you need to know. I have had 4 shots, all on target, and all have been goals. Precision in the shooting from the Reds. 100% accurate.
It was cagey a little bit at times in that first half, but
100% in everything we do. Ladies and gentlemen, 100% in the league, 100% shots on target. Yes. Wait! That's the first shot! That is terrible!
He got his move that he wanted, really, to a step up, he felt, to Liverpool.
Well, you've only got to look at the screen to see how successful, how positive he's been around goal.
Firmino. Daniel Sturridge. Is he going to tee up Mane for the hat-trick? Oh, he's pulling it back, but it's come to Emre Can. Ah, this time the defender gets the ball before he does any more damage. I'm having too much fun. Should I stop? Yeah. Let's milk this. I can make the scoreline even bigger. Sterling has to suffer as long as he's on the pitch over there.
Level pegging here, but in fact,
scoring more goals just to emphasize that he made the incorrect decision. Although, in truth, he did make. Oh wow, that was actually a really good shot from Ian. Oh, very unlucky that he didn't score that. In truth, Sterling made the correct decision because why would we want some ungrateful little punk-ass bitch on our team, who only cares about one thing, clearly, money. And just so you know, Manchester City fans, I haven't heard anything from them. Like, I don't know many Man City fans. In fact, I don't know any Man City fans. But
past his man there.
Man City fans don't generally brag about that. Sterling left Liverpool for City. Probably because they know if Sterling ever gets a better offer from any team, he'll probably be gone faster than you can. Which is, and forever will be, my grubbing prick. Daniel Sturridge begs himself a brace. Both of my strikers are on hat tricks now.
Just a quick check on the clock, and there are 20 minutes to go. Kolarov.
Sturridge and Mane. Firmino, he could tee up Mane. He is going to tee up Mane. Oh, no. A first shot that I didn't score from.
The goal, but they still got the ball.
Penalty! That would probably be, that would be a bit greedy if they give me a penalty. To be fair, it probably was not a penalty. I'm probably clutching at straws, to be honest.
That's all, company. Good to have.
Hey, that's three substitutions. Hey, Sterling has to endure this. Hey, thank you, Pep Boy. Oh, thank you to me for accidentally injuring Sergio Aguero, which means I couldn't take that little shithead off. He has to sit there. Money! There's the hat trick. A nice assist for Hannes Milner. The hat trick from Sadio Mane is complete. The demolition is, well, truly complete.
Not just three goals, but he's played really well.
What a way to end it all. Oh, no?
6-0 as the game is restarted. Gundogan. Nolito. Got on the ball in midfield. Well read by the player in that part.
Firmino. Sturridge. Sure, I was going to say, sure, the two players aren't going to score a hat-trick.
Good new one.
Boney. Silky Ilky. He, another player who started from the off in this final, but I had to only sell as a substitute when we play him in the League Cup. There's the full-time whistle. The FA Cup is added to the trophy case. 3-for-3. Perfect throughout. That is exactly what I do. Ladies and gentlemen, in the finish out season one, I will let you enjoy the miserable faces of the Manchester City players and the celebrations of a triple being successfully finished off with the addition of the FA Cup. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And I will see you all in Season 2. Ooh. Peace.
It's a magnificent feeling, and these players, I think defensively, they owe those defenders a big pat on the back, because their success has been based on that. The FA Cup winners. Joy here, total happiness. You play the game for these kind of moments. If you're in it, you want to win it, and they have won it. And no wonder they're going to the fans, because those supporters have played a huge part in this triumph. They've stuck by these players when they've needed them the most. Special scenes here. Team photo, and they're getting ready for it now. Yeah, one of those lovely scenes that you'll hang on the wall back at home. They've got the ball back, the interceptor got it for them.